I would like to tell about the table of the content. In social science, we are having two volumes of the books. In the first volume, we are having history, geography, civics, and economics. In history, we are having 5 lessons. Geography, we are having 5 lessons. In civics, we are having 3 units. The last one is economics, we are having 2 lessons. So, altogether, in volume 1, we are having 15 lessons. So today we are going to see the unit 1, geography, India, location, relief and drainage. As a learning objective, we are having importance of India's location. Second one is major physiographic divisions. Third one is compare the region of Great Indian Plains. Fourth, we have to understand the drainage system of India. The last one is differentiate between Himalayan rivers as well as Peninsula River. In introduction, India is the 7th largest country. We all know in the world level, India is the 7th largest country and the 2nd largest in Asia. So it is a part of the Asia but separated by the Himalayas. India is called as a subcontinent of the world. India accounts 2.4% of the total area in the world level. So next we will move for the India's land as well as water. India shares, now we will see about our neighboring countries. 15,200 kilometers long land with Pakistan in the west side, Afghanistan in the north west side. Thus, that I will explain in the direction. So, north, south, west, east. So, Pakistan, we know that in the west side, Pakistan. So, north west side, in between, we can see the Afghanistan. At the top of the north side, China, Nepal as well as Bhutan. So the eastern side we can see the Bangladesh and Myanmar. So neighboring countries west side Pakistan, northeast side, northwest side Afghanistan and north side China, Nepal, Bhutan as well as the east side Bangladesh and Myanmar. So these are the neighboring countries we are sharing. The longest border of the longest border is only the Afghanistan northwest side. It has the 4,156 kilometer geographic landmass. And the shortest border is the Afghanistan, that is a 106 kilometer. And also we are having India separates, Sri Lanka separated by the Pakistan. So south side you can see Sri Lanka. The coastal areas we are having in three side. The south side we can see the Indian Ocean. So it is having a two wing like a western side, Arabian Sea. And eastern side, Bay of Bengal. So these are the coastal areas. And also we are having 7,516 kilometer as a coastal area of the India. So next will why we call India as a subcontinent. So continent means we should have some of the characteristics possess. The first one is physiographic condition, climatic condition. Third one is natural vegetation and the minerals and the human resources it should be have. All these characters we are having in India also. That's why it's called India subcontinent. So next slide we will go major physiographic division of India. So physiographic division means we can also say our India is north, south, west, east, all over the India. We can say majestic Himalayan peak in north. So north we can see majestic Himalayan in the north. The great India. the west side. And the third one is breathtaking natural heritage in east side. It's also is called as Seven Sisters. The last one is beautiful beaches we can see in the south side. So it's also is India called vibrant, colorful, truly incredible of the nation. So next, major five physiographic divisions we'll see. First one is Himalayan mountains. Second one is the Great Northern Plains. Third one is the Peninsular Plateau. Fourth, the Indian Desert. The fifth one is the coastal plains as well as island. So first one, Himalayan mountains. Five major physiographic divisions. First one is the Himalayan mountains. Second, the Great Northern Plains. Third one is Peninsular Plateau. Fourth, the Indian Desert. Fifth one is the coastal plains as well as island. So first we will see about the Himalayan ranges. The Himalayan mountains are also is called as a northern mountains. Why? Because it's located in the north side. So it is called as a northern mountain. It consists of the youngest and loftiest mountain, and also mountain is chain. It formed only few million years ago due to the folding of the earth as well as tectonic forces. About this tectonic forces, we learned in 9th standard as the first two units, tectonic forces. It stretches for a distance of 2500 kilometers. So 2500 kilometer we can see northern mountains. It's called as a Himalayan mountains. And the width of the northern mountain varies from 500 kilometer in Kashmir to 200 kilometer in Arunachal Pradesh. So Kashmir, you can see the top of the India. Here you can see 500 kilometer width. In Arunachal Pradesh, you can see it is 200 kilometer. So width this vary from place to place. Himalayas is derived from the word Himalayas is derived from the Sanskrit word. It is also is mean the abode of snow. That function as a great wall. So Himalayas is a great wall of the India. It grouped into three division. First one is Trans Himalayas. The Trans Himalayas is the first area. It belongs to the Kashmir and the Jammu and Kashmir. So that is called Trans Himalayas. So Middle Himalayas is also called as the Himalayas. The third one is Eastern or Purvanchal. The first one is Trans Himalayas. You can see it is also is known as a Western Himalayas because it is the west side of the India. It is Western Himalayas, also Trans Himalayas. It lies in the North Himalayas range between Jammu and Kashmir and Tibetan Plateau. So it is located in Tibetan Plateau. It is also is called as a Tibetan Himalayas. It about 40 kilometer wide in the eastern side. So eastern side it is about. So till this Tibetan or the Trans Himalayas is also 40 kilometer wide in the eastern side, 225 kilometer in western side. So western side 225 kilometer, the eastern side only 40 kilometer wide ranges in Trans Himalayas. Prominent ranges, some of the prominent ranges: Jaskari, Ladakh, Kailash and Karakoram. This Kailash and Karakoram is a very much very important in the exercise of maps. So second one is the Himalayas. Himalayas, the second part Himalayas is a very important one. It constitutes the core part of the Himalayas. So altogether we can say this part is Himalayas. The first part is called as the Trans Himalayas. The middle part, that is also the core part, that is Himalayas. It was formed by the movement of the Angara land and Gondwana land. So this Angara and Gondwana land, that I will explain. So first of all, you can take a small area like a big landmass. So this is called Angara and Gondwana land. In between, you can see a Tepti Sea. So this is Angara land and this is Gondwana land. So this Angara land in the north side, Gondwana land in south side, in between Tepti Sea. So this Tepti Sea deposited and were Himalayas. So this area only uplifted by the compression. So Himalaya formed like a folded mountain. So Himalayas consist of many ranges. In Himalayas, we can see many ranges. So this Himalaya also is the second part of the mountain ranges. One is Greater Himalayas, second one is Lesser Himalayas, third one is the Shivaliks or Outer Himalayas. So the Greater Himalayas. So what does it mean by the Greater Himalayas? The Greater Himalayas rise abruptly like a wall north of the Lesser Himalayas. So Greater Himalayas is called the first row. This line only is the Greater Himalayas. So this is like a wall abruptly in the north of the Lesser Himalayas. It is having a width 25 km width and its average height 6000 meter. It received very less rainfall as compared to the Lesser Himalayas or maybe the Shivaliks. Physical weathering is also less in the place. Almost all the lofty peaks and located in the Greater Himalayas. Notable areas or notable hills or the ranges, you can say Mount Everest and Kanchenjunga. So Mount Everest is located in Nepal and Kanchenjunga located in Nepal as well as Sikkim. And then Mount Everest having a meter length 8,548. Kanchenjunga having a meter of 8,556 meter. These ranges are mostly continuous ranges. So that is called as the Greater Himalayas having a continuous ranges, having most prominent snow cover as well as many glaciers also we can find in this area. So that glaciers namely Gangotri, Yamunotri and Sikkim also. Next, the second part is Lesser Himalayas. So the first part is called Greater Himalayas. The second part is middle of the area is called as Lesser Himalayas. That is also is known as Himachal. In middle range of the Himalayas, height of this range varies from 3700 to 4500 with varies up to 80 km. In this region, extensive erosion. So in middle area that is called as Lesser Himalayas, we can see a most of the time erosion due to heavy rainfall. So that region is receiving a more rainfall as well as deforestation, and the third one is urbanization also happened. So important mountainous ranges and major hills also we can see in that area. Important mountain ranges Kirpanchal, Dauladabad and Mahabar. So these are the three mountainous ranges we can see in the Lesser Himalayas. The major hill stations, so these areas also is called a tourist spots. Similar Nainital, Darjeeling, Missouri, Almora and Raniken. These are the places you can see in the Lesser Himalayas, the middle Himalayas. It's also known as Himachal. The last one is Shivaliks or Outer Himalayas. I have mentioned three lines. So first one is the Greater Himalayas and the Shivaliks, and the third one is the third one is Shivalik or Outer Himalayas. It extended from Jammu and Kashmir. You can see the line from the Jammu and Kashmir. The Shivaliks you can see. It partly made by the debris brought by the Himalayan rivers. From the Himalayan rivers, it used to bring all the rubbish. It also called as a debris. We can see with 10 km in east side and 50 km in west side and most discontinuous ranges also this place. These are ideal site for development of settlement. So here we can see some of the settlement. So human settlement we can see in this area. Kurvanchal Hills, the third one is Kurvanchal Hills, offshoot of Himalayas. It extended northeastern states of India. Most of the hills are located along the border of the India and Myanmar. So this area you can see Kurvanchal, Kurvanchal Himalayas. It is Trans Himalayas, Himalayas, Indus, Hindus, Kurvanchal Hills. It's collective hills of number of hills name they have mentioned. Dafla, Abo, Mishmir, Patkar, Bung. Likewise, they have mentioned number of his name of Purvanchal. Importance of the last one is importance of Himalayas. So why this Himalayas we are having and what are the importance we are getting through the Himalayas? The first one is Himalayas blocks the southwest monsoon rain and cause heavy rainfall in North India. So southwest monsoon it used to arose from this side the India. Southwest monsoon it goes and strike the wind in the Himalayas. It used to give a heavy rainfall in this area of the Seven Sisters. Eastern Himalayas it used to give. So it forms a natural barrier and also sources for the many perennial rivers also. So perennial rivers used to originate from this Himalayas and many hill stations and pilgrim centers also we can see in this Himalayas. The many hill stations we can many hill stations as well as pilgrim centers we can see in the Himalayas. Pilgrim centers like Amarnath, Kedarnath, Badrinath and Vaishnavi Devi temple we can see. It provides raw material for the forest based industry, prevents cold wind blowing from Central Asia. So above India we can see Central Asia. So it prevents the blowing wind, cold wind and protects India from severe cold also. So these are the importance we see in this lesson. So second major physiographic division is the Great Northern Plain. So plain means it is suitable for the living area as well as the fertile land. So plains more fertile land it extending across 7 North Indian states. So main area is like this area. So Ganga plain is called as a fertile land. These deposited by Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. These rivers deposit enormous quantity of sediments along the foothills and floodplain. So these river used to bring all the fertile thing and deposit it in the plain area. Important characteristics of features. First one is Bhagar plain. Second one is Tri-Track. Third one is Bhagar plain and Kadar plain. Last one is Delta plain. So first one is Bhagar plain. So this Bhagar plain made up of gravels. So gravels means in Tamil they can say Sarale Mud. So and assorted sediment also we can see. It lies to the south of Sivaliks from west to east side. This plain is not suitable for the cultivation since it is the full of gravel sand and only big trees we can able to see in this Bhagar plain. Second one is Tri-Track. So this zone excessive dampness, thick forest and rich wildlife also we can see. Since it is a thick forest, it is a suitable for the wildlife. It lies in the south of Bhagar plain. This tract wider in eastern part. So eastern part you can see a bunch of trees in the forest area and especially in Brahmaputra due to heavy rainfall. In present many of the dry forests have been cleared for the cultivation. So this area is a dry plain. This area is they were cleared for the cultivation. So the third one is Bhagar plain. So this Bhagar plain is a very important one. It is also called as a older alluvium. It lies above the flat limits of the rivers. Soil is dark in color. So in this area soil is dark in color, rich in humus and humus content and well drained, useful for agriculture. So we saw the three first plain. One is Bhagar plain, second one is Tri-Track, the third one is Bhagar plain. This Bhagar plain only is a very much suitable for the agriculture. The fourth one is the Kadar plain, new alluvium. So Bhagar plain is an older alluvium, the Kadar plain is a new alluvium. So new alluvium, this tracks along the courses of the rivers. Kadar also is called as a bedland. So it enriched for the fresh deposit because it's called as a newer alluvium. It's also is a fresh deposits of silt every year during the rainy season. You can see this Kadar plain as a full of deposits. It consists of sand, silt, clay and mud. Highly fertile area also like same Bhagar plain. The last one is Delta plain, that is also extensive of Kadar land and it covers about square kilometer. It also consists of older mud, new mud, marsh area, and uplands also called chars, and marshy areas are called bills. So delta plain, we are having two types of uplands, two types of area. One is upland, another one is marshy. Upland is called as a chars and marshy areas is called as a bills. So the third physiographic division is a peninsular plateau. Peninsular plateau. Plateau means it's like a table. So we can see a mountainous region and the flat top. Lies to the south of Great Northern Plains. It covers 16 lakh square kilometer, and it's about half the total area of the country. It is an old rocky plateau region.